Hello everyone, and welcome to my playthrough of Super Mario Land. I know some of you viewers might remember that I played through this game, and some of you like long-time viewers might remember I played through this game twice. This is going to be the final time, hopefully the final time. Basically, I'm doing this again just because I have better equipment and stuff like that from the previous two playthroughs. So hopefully it should look better and sound better too. Okay, but Super Mario Land is it was a launch title for the original Game Boy, and this was actually my first game. Not like if you don't count Tetris, because that came bundled with the Game Boy, but this was my first non-bundled game, and it's a really good game. I have a lot of memories playing this one, and if you have memories playing this one, let me know. But in addition to the Game Boy, it's also available on the 3DS Virtual Console. I think it's like $3 or $4, maybe more than that. I don't remember because I only have the cartridge. But anyway, let's get started. This playthrough is going to be pretty short. This is a very short game. There are four worlds with, I think there's three levels each. It's been a bit since I played. But, oh wait, I think I can go in here. Yeah, there we go. So yeah, it's not very long. What I'm going to do is split the playthrough in, well, the main part of the playthrough is going to be in like two parts. But there's like a new game plus that's basically unlocked when you beat the game, and I'm actually going to go through that too. So this whole playthrough is going to be like four parts, and each part's not going to be very lengthy. But anyway, I'm playing this on the Game Boy Player, which is an add-on for the GameCube that allowed you to play Game Boy, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance games on your TV. And so I'm playing on that, and I'm able to record on using this method. Okay, but Super Mario Land it's an interesting game because it was a lot different than Super Mario Brothers. Actually, what's interesting is Shigeru Miyamoto, the creator of Super Mario, was not involved in this game, and the composer for Super Mario Brothers, Koji Kondo, was not involved in this game either. Instead, Hip Tanaka composed the soundtrack. That's why it's so different. There's no like classic Mario tunes. I mean, the soundtrack to this game is actually really good in its own right, but there's no familiar Mario tunes from previous games in this one. But yeah, what I like about this game is each world in this game is very distinct. It has their own like setting and stuff like that. But I mean, it's a fun game. It's aged a little bit, but I still think it's fun today. In my opinion, it is. Okay, for this part, you can either go on the top or bottom. I went on the top because you could play a bonus game and earn extra lives or a flower, which I'm going to get. Darn it. Yeah, I already have it. Well, actually, this is it's not a fire flower, it's called a. Or, you don't shoot fireballs, they're called super balls. Oddly enough, but they're like these spheres that can actually bounce off of stuff, which is pretty neat. And something about this game, in addition to having different music and stuff like that, and a different development team, the enemies are pretty different too. I mean, you see like the Goombas, but they're actually not Goombas. Actually, what's interesting is it wasn't until the 3DS version, the 3DS port came out, that a lot of these enemies actually got English names. And in this game, instead of Goombas, they have Goombos. And instead of the Koopa Troopas, they have Bombshell Koopas. Because of the fact that when you step on them, they explode. They turn into like bombs and explode. Okay. Oh, one other thing. The bosses in this game. There's actually four different bosses. Well, actually five, because there's two at the very end instead of just one. And it's interesting because in Super Mario Brothers, you only basically fought Bowser. Well, oh shoot, I fell. Bowser and his clones, I guess you could call them. But in this game, there's distinct bosses from one another. The jumping in this game is kind of, it's hard to describe. When you drop down pretty quick. Well, it's hard to describe. Hang on. When you jump up, you slowly start to pick up speed. There you go. So I'm trying to get used to it because, like I said, it's been a while since I played this one. And I got that one up again, actually. Oh no, there's just that one up there. Yeah, I got that one up there, so that kind of made up for the lost life. And hopefully I can get more from the bonus games. I mean, this game is actually not that difficult. I mean, maybe your first time through, but if you've played this a bunch of times, then it's really not that bad. Okay, so that's already the first two levels down, and then the third one is like the boss level. Oh, I didn't even mention the storyline of the game. Okay, basically, there's different... It takes place outside the Mushroom Kingdom. It's, I'm probably butchering the pronunciation of this, but it's like Sarasaland, and the ruler here is Princess Daisy. This is actually her first appearance, and, this would be, like, one of her last ones until, like, later on. Like, she really wasn't in a lot of games. I think there were some cameos, but other than that, she didn't reappear until, like a full appearance until Mario Tennis for the Nintendo 64, and that was in 2000. So, yeah. This game came out in, like, late 80s. I think it was 89. I might be wrong about that, though. It's just off the top of my head. Yeah, when my parents got the Game Boy, it was kind of for me, but it was also for them, because, you know, they weren't really into video games, but they kind of played a few. Like, they had the Atari, and then they got this. They loved Tetris. I think they still play Tetris nowadays. Maybe not as much. But, yeah, they got this, too. Because, you know, ever since I was, like, little, I was, like... I loved playing Super Mario games, like, on my cousin's NES. Like, they would, they would sometimes let me play, but for the most part, I was... You know, I had a controller that wasn't plugged in or, you know, something like that. But even then, just watching, it was just, like, a lot of fun. So that's pretty much how I get started on playing Super Mario games. Someone up there. I actually forgot there was a 1-up. I was just hitting those to see if something would be hidden there. Okay. But also what's cool is the Super Ball can pick up coins for you. Just gonna knock this guy out. Yeah, so some parts of the ceiling fall down. When you unlock like the New Game Plus, it's actually a more difficult version of the game, and there's more like ceiling tiles that fall down. There's another flower here. Those guys, they spit fireballs at you. They're pretty easy to beat, though, with or without the Super Ball. You can just step on them like this. Okay, here's the boss. I'm not even going to try to pronounce his name, because I don't even remember it offhand. But what you can do is you can run under him when he jumps up and step on that switch, or if you have the Super Ball, you can just pelt him. That's it. Yeah, he's a really easy first boss. Actually, most of the bosses in this game are pretty easy, too. I think the last one, since he just doesn't stop attacking you until one of you is, like, dead. I guess he's the most difficult one. Okay, thank you, Mario. Oh, Daisy. yeah, that's not really Daisy. It's like an imposter. You don't actually see Daisy until the very end of the game, and that's supposed to be Daisy. I mean, her artwork, you know, it looks more like Daisy. Oh, I got the flower again. But yeah, in-game, yeah, that's 8-bit Daisy there. I love the soundtrack of this game. It's so good. Like, I really like this theme, too. A lot of the music in this game, like, Nintendo kind of... I don't want to say ignores the Super Mario Land games, but they don't really reference them too much. I mean, some elements from those games reappeared in later ones, like, you know, obviously Daisy is in the Mario series again. There's another Fire Flower... Super Ball Flower, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, Daisy's reappeared, and... In Super Smash Bros. Brawl, the underground theme from this game, the one that was in the previous level, that was in Smash Bros. Brawl in the Mushroomy Kingdom underground stage. There's another... Well, actually, I think on the left side, if you were Small Mario, that'd be Mushroom and then a Super Ball Flower. But yeah, other than that, like, a lot of the... Other than some, like, mentions in, like, Daisy's biography and stuff like that, this game hasn't really been mentioned. There's another one. Yeah, later on, you'll be like, oh man, I wish I had a Fire Flower. Keep calling it a Fire Flower. It's just weird, because it's not a Fire Flower in this game. But yeah, the power-ups will be a lot more rare. These fish bones, you can just step on them, you know. Okay, and the same thing, this game actually had a sequel, Super Mario Land 2. That one, it's interesting seeing them side by side, because this game, like, graphically resembles Super Mario Brothers, but Super Mario Land 2 looks like Super Mario World a little bit, so... Definitely stepped it up in the graphics department. But, you know, this was a launch title, so... You know, obviously, it didn't look as good until, or compared to later games like Super Mario Land 2. But that game introduced Wario, and I am going to redo a playthrough of that. I uploaded that years ago, but it just... Man, it'll look better. Hopefully it'll sound better, too. Because I have a new headset. Well, since then, I got a new headset. It's not great, but hopefully it sounds pretty good. Okay, these guys, these, like, seahorses or dragons, whatever, they spit fireballs. But you can just step on them, too. Yeah, I would love to see, like, I don't know about, like, a remake. Oh, shoot. Yeah, I messed that up. Oh, well. A remake of this game. Nintendo did announce, it's called Mario Maker for the Wii U. You can make your own levels. I'm sure you could remake, like, levels in this game and that. Maybe not that great, but somewhat resembling some of the levels here. Alright, I'm actually going to try to do this. Let's see. Okay, two lives. It's better than the Fire Flower. I would have taken anything but the Super Ball Flower, not Fire Flower. Yeah, some of the enemies get kind of weird as you go on through the game. Like, they have, like, that robot. That robot actually, like, flings its head at you. It's interesting. Okay, this has the same layout as one of the secret areas we saw before. It's a little bit different. There's no, like, mushroom or fire... or Super Ball Flower. God, that's gonna get on my nerves. There's coins, though. Oh yeah, for the Game Boy player, you can actually change the colors of, like, the color palette, but I just went with this because, you know, some of the color schemes look like barf. They're really bad. This one kind of resembles the Game Boy. It's not, you know, the Game Boy was like black and like a shade of green. This one's like just black and white, pretty much, and gray. Okay, thankfully I made that jump. Usually I die there. Oh, there's that robot I was talking about. Oh yeah, if you're small Mario, you can hop down here and crawl under there. It's like another way. You can actually avoid all the enemies and stuff like that. Actually, there's a couple Goombos down there. Oh, but there is a star here. The Starman music is great. I can't remember the name of the theme, but it's like a classical theme. It's kind of like redid it for the Game Boy. Oh, okay. It's kind of weird in this game, like... you know, typically, Mario will change colors when he has a Starman, but in this game he just flashes because, yeah, there weren't, like I said, there really weren't that many colors on the Game Boy. Pretty much had green, a darker shade of green, and, like, black. That was it. That's why I really liked, well, there was a peripheral on the Super Nintendo called the Super Game Boy, which I also have. That basically let you plug in a Game Boy game. And certain Game Boy Color games, too. Not all of them work, though. You put it into, like, this cartridge adapter, and then plug that into the Super Nintendo, like, the cartridge slot, and then you could play your Game Boy games on your TV. And I remember when that came out, I saw a commercial for it, and they were advertising, I think, that and, Donkey Kong for the Game Boy? I messed that up. It's just called, like, Game Boy Donkey Kong, or some people call it Donkey Kong 94, but that was one of the Super Game Boy Enhanced games. Basically, it had, like, a specific color palette made for the Super Game Boy, and the sound was different, too. Like, in that game, you actually heard Pauline yell help. Unlike the Game Boy version, it was just, like, a weird a weird cry with a weird pitch or whatever. But yeah, sadly... Oh, shoot, I messed up. But yeah, the Game Boy Player doesn't have, like, Super Game Boy enhancements, because basically what the Game Boy Player is doing... is acting like a Game Boy Advance. So, yeah, it doesn't have any of the enhancements of the Super Game Boy. So if you want any of those, you have to play it on that. Which I might do. I mean, like I said, I'm planning on redoing Super Mario Land 2, and I might do Game Boy Donkey Kong as well. I have some plans on doing that. Hopefully. We'll see. Okay, this is... Oh, wait, no, not yet. The boss is coming up soon, but not yet. But yeah, that's another thing I like about this game. There are vehicles, like there's a submarine, and then later on, in the final level of the game, you have the airplane, the Sky Pop, I think it's called. It's neat. Actually, this spells out, was it Mario Land? Or, oh, it's just Mario. In Super Mario Land 2, there's another part that spells out, like, Mario or Mario Land. I guess it's just something the developers, like a tradition. Yeah, this is the boss. Actually, there's like two things here. This seahorse dragon and then this like this bubble. Which actually, if you look at the official art for it, it's supposed to be an eyeball. But yeah, as long as you avoid the eyeball and then the little eyeballs and the fireballs or whatever, he's easy. Okay. But we're going to see the fake Daisy here. And then after this, I'm going to end this part. I don't know how long this ran on, but hopefully it wasn't too lengthy. Okay, here's Daisy again. Of course, it's a fake Daisy. Let's see what enemy it is. Can't remember. That was the octopus thing. Okay, I'm gonna do the bonus game and then end this part. Oh, whatever. Okay, thanks for watching, everybody.